Hi and welcome back, it's Vicky here with a new art journal project. Today I'm going to play with my new Pebbio paints. These paints are really amazing to work with and you will see what I mean later on today. Now I have to say that this is not a sponsored video, I don't do sponsored videos, I just happened to see the products while I was on Creativation and loved them. Now I will be using three different paints, the Vitrail, the Prism and the Moon. Now all three of them have different properties and I'm going to explain each and every one of them separately. So the Vitrail is a paint that is made for painting on top of glass, which means that this paint is transparent and of course it comes in a huge range of colors, but you will see that you can use it for the technique that I'm going for today. This paint is really concentrated. If I open up the bottle, it looks as if it is black, but this is good because actually you can thin it down and this bottle can take you for a long, long time. I am going to show you how to do it later on. And now let's move on to the next two paints. These are from the Pebbio Fantasy line. There are two actual collections here. The one is called Prism that you can see here, and this creates a beautiful honeycomb effect. You don't have to add silicone or any other mixative to create this effect. This is a high-end paint that includes all the good stuff inside, so when you use it, it's going to create the effect for you without you having to do anything else. And of course it comes in a huge range of colors as well. And the second collection of fantasy paints that they have is called Moon. Again, it comes in a huge range of colors. And this one, when you apply it, it creates a beautiful hammered effect. Now I will be using all of these paints today and you will see how everything works out. Now normally you can use these paints to do some pouring, which is very trendy these days, and you can work on a canvas or a hardcore surface like these art panels by Ranger. They work beautifully on top of those. However, I want to try today something different and I want to play with them on top of paper. This is watercolor paper and I want to create a page for my art journal. But again, you can do what I'm doing today on top of a canvas. And here's a fun thing, there are canvases by Pebbio, these are called art panels and they have this raised frame all around, which means that if you pour paint on top of it, you're not going to make a mess all over your craft area. So for today I'm going to work on a watercolor page from my 6x6 disc bound journal, and since I want to use these paints, I need to make sure that I cover it up completely with gesso. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to prime my surface with gesso, which means that it's going to turn into a non-porous surface and all those paints that I'm going to apply are not going to just soak inside. Now first of all I want to apply a coat of the Vitrail. This is turquoise and you can see how concentrated it is and how dark it looks, as if it is black. So I'm going to thin it down so that I get a lovely color, and at the same time, just with one drop, I can have lots and lots of color. So this is just a thinner that I'm using, and you can make it as concentrated as you want. I don't use a lot, just a couple of drops here. And I'm using a pipette, which makes my life easy and I avoid any mess. Now in my page here, I have applied gesso, just like I said before, making sure that everything is nice and dry. And now I'm going to use the paint that I have prepared and thinned down and apply a very thin coat. Now you will probably see some texture coming out. That's just because when I applied gesso, I did that with a spatula because I didn't want to have a completely smooth background. Here I'm using a spatula to help the paint spread out, and I avoid using brushes with these paints just because I don't want to have to do a lot of cleaning later on. Remember, these are not water soluble paints. This means that they have a little bit of odor, but it's already spring in Greece, so I have my windows open and I'm good to go. Now I will move on and use two shades of gold. One of them is Fantasy, the other one is Moon. You don't have to use both of them. You are good to go if you want to create a similar look just with one gold. So in the end you will see that you can create the same look just by buying three paints only. A shade of blue, some gold and some white. Which means that it makes it easy for you to try them out and see if you like these techniques. I apply my paint with a popsicle stick, so again I'm not using any brushes, so I don't have to do any cleaning at all at the end. I am applying now the lighter shade of gold, And remember that before you use those fantasy paints, you need to give it a good stir, because when you store them, all the good stuff are quite heavy and they go and sink at the bottom. So just give it a good stir, but don't shake the bottles before you use the paint, because this way you will create bubbles inside the paint bottle that you don't really want to use on your project. I'm moving my page up and down, helping those colors to blend together. They have already started to react, the fantasy paints, which are the two gold ones at the bottom, and they are creating all kinds of beautiful effects. And now I'm going to go and add some white. I'm going for an ocean themed today, so this is going to end up looking as an abstract ocean. And I'm adding the waves now. The paint that I'm using here is Moon, Fantasy Moon, and the color is Pearl. Again, I apply everything with a popsicle stick, and I'm also going to add some abstract lines on my sea as well. These are not going to look like that. Those paints react on their own. They have a mind of their own. They are really difficult to control. So don't go for the perfect look, just go for an abstract look, and you will be really happy with the outcome. This was the first time I used those paints. I find them really easy to work with, since you are going for an abstract look, and I had so much fun working with them. I'm definitely going to use them again, and you will see more videos of me using those for lots of beautiful backgrounds for my art journal. When you give your page a little bit of an angle, you will see that all those paints move and blend together and create beautiful effects. However, at some point you want to stop that happening. But since I'm working on a page, it was quite difficult, since it is a little bit warped. That's not the case when you work on a canvas, of course. But I had to make it work, so here is my workaround. I'm just using a printer paper underneath, and I have applied some double-sided tape, and now I'm pressing my work on top of it. So you can see now it's nice and flat. And of course, you can add as many layers as you like on top of it, and then you have to leave it on its own to dry. Now, in my case, it took about 24 hours to dry, so I went back the next morning, and it was completely dry, but I guess it depends on how much paint you add on top of your project, as well as the climate. So here we are, about an hour later. Now I have transferred it on a hard cardstock, which is nice and clean, so that it's not too messy for you guys and you can see exactly what I'm doing. And I'm going to add a little bit of glitter in different areas. The paint is not dry at all yet, which means that this glitter is going to soak into the paint and it's going to stick nicely there. I'm using Champagne Glass Glitter, and this is by Stampendous. I'm going to link all the products that I'm using down below, just like always, into different shops so you can check the prices. And I think that the Pebbio paints are on sale at the moment, 15% off at Joggles, but you will find all the links that you need down below. And just because I want some touches of white, I'm also going to sprinkle this chunky white embossing powder. I'm not going to melt it, I just want to add it, and it's going to stick nicely where the wave is, just like I did with the glitter. And here is my beautiful background 24 hours later. Everything is nice and dry, and I love that it has a beautiful shine. The glitter and the embossing powder is nicely stuck there. Nothing falls out. So I'm just going to finish it off. I don't want to cover it up completely to turn it into a journal page for my art journal. I want to add just a few touches here and there, but I want to keep that background to be the focal point of my page. So I'm just going to stick down a little fishing net, this anchor that I had in my stash forever, and a cheap quote from Tim Holtz collection. For sticking everything down, I'm going with a little bit of Nouveau Deluxe glue. I'm also going to use my hot glue gun to secure down the metal anchor, just to make sure that this is not going to fall out. And since I had my glue gun on my table, I used that to stick down the cheap quote as well. So all I have to do now is to just use my scissors and cut out all the fishing net that sticks out of the page. And here is my finished page that I absolutely love. I think that I am going to recreate that into the big canvas that I showed you earlier. So now I'm going to use some metal rings and turn this into a new art journal where I can add even more pages as I go. Now I like to use metal rings just because I like the feel of them. I will link the ones that I'm using right now down below, and they come in many different colors and sizes, but you can also get the plastic rings, which are way cheaper, and they come in many different colors and sizes as well. So that was the project for today. Don't forget, you will find all the links of the products that I used down below in the description area. I hope that you had fun today and that you got inspired to give those paints a go. And by grabbing just three colors, you can create this beautiful background. Here are some close-up photos. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.